Good afternoon, students. We are starting with a new chapter, that is theory of rotating magnetic field and three phase induction motor. So we are going to see in this chapter theory of rotating magnetic field. How does the rotating magnetic field is generated or created? And also we are going to see three phase induction motor. So basically in the last lecture, single phase induction motor, we saw that to make the motor self start, what we did, we have to create rotating magnetic field, right? Whenever we give single phase AC supply, alternating flux are produced, right? We produced alternating flux due to AC supply. What happens? Alternating flux are produced. So those students who are new, so in 11th standard you have learnt the generation of AC. How does the alternating current is generated? So we will just quickly revise it for the new students. So whenever, so this is the magnet, north pole, south pole, and this is our conductor. Okay, so according to Faraday's law, what it says, whenever the moving conductor, whenever the rotating conductor is placed in the magnetic field, EMF is induced. That means whenever this conductor at one should be moving, one must be in motion at this one time, the conductor must be rotating, or this magnets must be rotating, right? So the law states that whenever the conductor placed in magnetic field is rotating, the EMF is induced in this conductor. Okay, that means that is alternating current. Okay, so this is how the generation of AC is stated. So I hope you understood. So it is very simple. We have to take the magnet, we have to create this magnetic field. Here magnetic field will be created, and this is our conductor. So what we have to do, there must be motion, right? Whenever this conductor will rotate, then what will happen? This flux, it will cut this flux, right? This conductor will cut this flux, and due to this, what will happen? EMF will be induced in this conductor. So this is alternating, right? This is alternating. So this is our waveform. Okay, this is our waveform. So this is zero. This is the maximum value. Here the maximum value, this is called the amplitude, the maximum value. So whenever this conductor, it is in position 90 degree, when it is in 90 degree, it attains the maximum value. And this is at 180. And after this 180, it will again cross. It the same will repeat, but in the opposite direction. So it is called as alternating. You have learned, we have to take angles, different angles, and after plotting, we get this waveform. So here, this is the alternating current. So this is how it works. So it is in positive, then it goes in negative, and it completes one rotation, right? So it is in one rotation. So this is given, and EMF induced is given by E is equal to E max sine theta. Okay, E max sine theta. So theta is nothing but this angle. Okay, this is the angle. Now this is not rotating magnetic field. This will not produce rotating magnetic field. It is alternating, right? So in our motors, we require rotating magnetic field. We need to rotate the rotor, right? So alternating current cannot. We have to produce rotating magnetic field. So as I told you in earlier also, in single phase induction motor, single phase supply was given, single phase AC supply. So it creates alternating flux, or it creates alternating, it does not create rotating magnetic field, right? So to create rotating magnetic field, what we did, we splitted the winding, that is single phase winding, into two windings, right? Indirectly what we did, we created two phases. Okay, so while we created the two phases, the rotating magnetic field was created. Right, the single phase cannot create rotating magnetic field, but two phase can create the rotating magnetic field. So in this part, in the first part, we are going to learn how this two-phase supply can create rotating type magnetic field. So we will see first that is two-phase supply. Two-phase supply. If the two-phase supply is connected to two-phase winding, okay, two-phase supply is connected to two-phase winding, or three-phase supply connected to three-phase winding. So this must be situated in the same magnetic core. Okay, same magnetic core. Then what happens? The magnetic field is produced. That magnetic field is rotating magnetic field. Okay, so whenever we give the two-phase supply to the two-phase winding, or whenever we give three-phase supply to three-phase winding, which are located or which are in the same magnetic core, then what happens? The field produced is rotating type. Okay, it is rotating type. So we will first see for two-phase supply. So what does it mean by two-phase supply? There will be the two conductors. So this is the one and this is two. To get the rotating magnetic field, there must be some phase difference. Okay, so this is B, this is A. Now it will rotate in this direction. Okay, this will rotate in this direction. So B is leading here, right? That means B will reach this maximum value first. Okay, this B conductor, this winding will reach the maximum value first. And then A. Why? Because it is cutting flux first. Okay, are you getting the point? So here waveform will be, so for one conductor it is like this. Okay, for one conductor it is like this. And when we have introduced the another conductor, it will be like this. So this is the amplitude. This will be constant. It will not change. So this is the 90 degree. Okay. So here what is happening? These two are placed. So here B is leading. So the flux of B coil should be leading flux of the A. Why? Because they have 90 degree. Right? They have difference of 90 degree. This B is leading than this A. Now this is B. This is B and this is A. I will draw it here once again. So here this is the 90. This is its amplitude. And from here, okay, so this is B and this is A. So here you can see this B is reaching maximum first and then this A is reaching the maximum value later. So their difference is 90 degree. So how we can say? So here the B is reaching the maximum value, right? And this is 0, this is 90 degree, this is 180 degree, this is 360. Okay, so here this is 90. Here 90 at the 0 position, the B is reaching the maximum value. Okay, it is reaching the maximum value. And after 90 degrees, A is reaching the maximum value. Why is this so? Because we have placed them 90 degree apart, right? So now here we will draw the vector diagram and see the direction, or is it rotating or not. So the two phase, it is rotating. So we will consider certain points. Now here this is the first point. Okay, at zero this is the first point. Consider this is the first point. Now here at this point it is second point. So this is the second point. Okay, and at this 90 it is third point. And here it is fourth point. Okay, so we have taken here certain points. So to draw the vector diagram, what we will going to do, we are going to take the instantaneous values of flux. Okay, instantaneous values of flux. So this is the A and this is the B. Okay, so now here, considering the instantaneous values, they are apart by the 90 degrees, right? So in our vector or on the graph also, the y-axis and x-axis will represent the flux of A and flux of B. So here x-axis will represent, so this is the our x-axis. So this axis will represent the A, okay, flux of A, and y-axis will represent, this is the y-axis and it will represent the flux of B. Okay, the value of B, instantaneous value of B will be represented on y-axis, and on x-axis the instantaneous values of flux of A will be represented on a-axis. Okay, now this is why, as I told you, why we have taken this angle, that is 90 degree, because both these fluxes have phase difference of 90. Right, here they have placed at 90 degree. So here this B value reaches the maximum value at the 0 instant, at the 0 degree, and at 90 degree the difference is 90 degree, and at the 90 degree A reaches the flux. So here we have taken A on the x-axis, A flux, instantaneous values of flux A, and for the B it is y-axis. Now consider point 1. At the point 1, that is 0 degree, you can see this A is 0, right? A is at the 0 point. So what we can write here? We will add the number 1, that at the instant number 1, the flux of coil B will be B1 and A will be A1. At instant 1, the flux will be B1 and A1. Okay. Now here A1 is 0. At instant 1, A1 is 0. So I will just write here A1 because it is 0. And B, it is B1 and it is in positive direction. So I will write here B1. So to find out the resultant, how will be its resultant? This will be the only resultant. Okay, I will give the name R1. So this is the resultant of first. So this is A1 at is 0 and this is B1. Okay, now at point 2. So at point 2, here you can see this is first one. Okay, this is first. So here on this second point, A2, we will call it as B2 and A2. So first, at this point, at the second point, this flux, this waveform of A, it is positive. So we will write here A2. Okay. And now for the B also, it is in positive direction. So we will write here B2. Okay. Now how we will take the resultant? So we will just take the resultant of this like this. So this is the resultant R2. So here is the R1. At the point 1, the resultant is this. At the point 2, resultant is this. Now at the point 3. For at point 3 means, we are going to take this here. So here, that means before, after 90 degree, we are taking the point, right? So this is 90 and our point is after this 90 degree, right, somewhere around 93, 94, 95, okay. So, whenever we extend this line of the 3, it will cross the downward line, okay. So, here, this 3 point is touching where? So, this for the A flux, it is touching in positive direction. So, we will draw here A3, okay. So, we will draw here A3. So, we will just draw same A3 as A3. And now, this line is cutting our B flux at the downward direction, that means the at the negative. So we will just draw here B3. Okay, so this is B3. So we will take the resultant, and this is our resultant of B3, that will be R3. So your resultant is R1, resultant is R2, and at 3, B3, A3, resultant is R3. Now at point number 4. So what is point number 4? Here at 180 degrees. Okay, at 180 degrees. So here the flux will be B4 and A4. A resultant will be A4. Now at the point 4, you can see the A is 0. Right? A is 0. So this is the waveform of A. Here A is 0. So I will write here A4, and B is, so it is cutting in downward direction. Right? So here it will be B4. So our resultant will be in this direction. It is R4. Now if we extend these numbers, or we'll extend this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on, then what will happen? So look at the first resultant. At the first point, resultant is in this direction. For the second point, in this direction. In third, in this direction. In fourth, in this direction. Right? That means it is rotating. Right? The resultant, you can see the resultant, it is rotating. So the flux produced here is rotating flux. So the whenever we give two phase supply is given to two phase winding, the flux produced is rotating type. I hope you have understood how I calculated this resultant and all. What I did, just I substituted here points at the zero, then before 90 degree, and then after 90 degree we have to take one point, and at 180 degree. So at zero point, the waveform of A, that is flux of A, is zero, and B is V1, that is it is in positive direction. So I just substitute here the values on y axis, on x axis. Now here the B is crossing the negative, right? So I just extended this, and on the negative I plotted the numbers. So this is how for the two phase supply we get the rotating magnetic flux. Now we will see for the three phase supply. So in two phase there were two windings, they were 90 degree apart from each other. Now here similarly there are three phase supply, there is three phase supply which is connected to three phase winding. Now here they were at 90 degree apart, but in three phase it is 120 degree apart from each other. So there are three windings. Now consider, this is first winding, this is a second winding, and this is the third winding. Okay, so the angle between them is 120 degree. So the angle here is 120 degree. So here the windings are placed from each other, the phase difference is of 120 degree. The windings are displaced by 120 degree, and they are supplied by the three phase AC supply. So now two phase, the waveform was like this, right? Now here in three phase there will be three windings, so there will be the waveform. So I will just draw here the waveform. So to draw the three phase waveform, first draw our normal alternating. So this is our normal waveform of AC. Okay, now just mark the amplitude, just mark this, because these values will not change. So this is our amplitude. Now what you have to do, so this 180 we have to part it in three parts. Okay, so this is first, this is second. So 1, 2, 3. Similarly here, this is first, this is second, and this is third. So 1, 2, 3. Now, this upper part, this two last two points, we have to connect them in upward direction. So here, this is the how we have to connect. And then just extend it. Okay, and then just extend it. And similarly, here also. Okay, now this two parts, these two points which are first. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to just join this and then extend. So just extend it. Okay, so this is how we have to draw the waveform of a three phase supply. Okay, this is the waveform. So here this will produce the flux, let it will say phi 1, this phi 2, and this will be phi 3. Okay. So what we did here, we are dealing with the three phase supply. So three phase supply is given to the three phase winding. So these windings are placed, they are displaced by 120 degree apart from each other. Okay. So this is the first winding, this is second winding, and this is the third winding. Okay. So here the angle between them is 120. Okay, this is the angle, that is 120. So this is how we draw it vectorly, and this is our waveform. Okay, so this is the first of the first winding, this is of second, and this is of third. So now this will be clear. I have colored them, but here you can see this is the flux of first. Okay, this is flux of first, this is second, and this is third winding. Okay, so they create a rotating magnetic field. So we will learn how we learned earlier with the vector diagram, with the resultants, we will run the same here. So here now, this is at 0 degree, this is 60, this is 180, and this is 120. Okay, so this point is 0, this point is 60, this is 120, and this is 180. Okay, now here what we did, these are the three windings, they are displaced by 120 degrees apart. Now what we are going to do is, so as I told you the formula, that is E is equal to E max sine theta. Theta is the angle. Now here we are dealing with the flux. So what we will do, phi 1 for the first, so we will write here phi 1 is equal to phi max, that is phi m sine omega t. Okay, it is angle omega t. Now phi 2, so phi 2 for the second winding, it will be phi m sine omega t minus 120. Why omega t minus 120? Because phi 2 starts at 120 degrees, right? Phi 2 starts at 120 degrees. Here you can see the phi 2 starts at 120 degree. Correct. So it is lagging by 120 degree to this. So we have written here phi 2 omega t minus 120. Now phi 3. So what we can write here? Phi m sine omega t minus 240. Why? Because it is starting at 240. Here you can see, just take this as reference. So this is our sine omega t, then this will be sine omega t minus 120, and this will be sine omega t minus 240. Okay, is this clear? Now we will see the vector diagrams. Now here what I am going to do is, at zero, okay, at this zero position, we will find out the phi 1, phi 2 and phi 3. Now here phi 1, after substituting the values, what will be the answer? Phi 2, what will be the answer? And phi 3, what will be the answer? Now at the phi 1, for phi 1, this is the phi 1, okay, this is the phi 1. So it is 0, right? It is 0. So whenever we substitute here 0 instead of this omega t, the answer will be 0, okay? So here answer will be 0. Now for phi 2, so what is phi 2? This is phi 2. So this is like this. Okay, now here it is 0, right? So here what I will substitute, phi 2 is equal to phi m sine omega t. I will write here phi 2 is equal to phi m sine omega t is 0 minus 120. So if you solve this, you will get the answer sine minus 120 is phi m. What will be the answer? It will be root 3 by 2, but it will be minus root 3 by 2. So our answer here will be minus root 3 by 2 phi m. And similarly to phi 3, what will be the answer here? After we substitute here 0, we will get the answer as root 3 by 2. This will be phi m root 3 by 2. So clear up to this. Now what we are going to do is, we are going to draw the values, or we are going to draw the vector out of these values. Now here you can see, we have to take this as reference. Okay, so this is for phi 1, this is for phi 2, this is for phi 3. Now here phi 1 is 0, right? So no need to draw this. Now here phi 2, here you can see phi 2, it is negative, right? So what we have to do here, we have to just draw this in opposite direction. Okay, we have to just draw this in opposite direction. Why? Because phi 2 is minus root 3 by 2 phi m. So what we have to do, this will come in this direction. Okay, this is negative side. So this will be phi 2, that is equal to minus root 3 by 2 phi m. Okay, why we have not taken phi 1? Because it is 0. Okay, we have cancelled this, it is 0. Now this phi 2 is minus root 3 by 2 phi m. So what we did, we just changed the direction of this vector and we have drawn here. Now what about phi 3? So phi 3 is positive, root 3 by 2. So we will keep it as it is. So this is phi 3, it is root 3 by 2 phi m. Okay. Now here, by the parallelogram law, by the parallelogram law, what we can do? We can find out the resultant. Now, before that, what is the angle between this? So, angle here is 60 degree. How 60 degree? This, what we have did, we have just extended this to the negative value. So, the angle here will be half, that is 60 degree. So, here the angle is half. So, according to the parallelogram law, what we can do? We can find the resultant as the magnitude is same. Okay, magnitude is same. But here the magnitude is same, so we can draw here the resultant according to the parallelogram law. So what is the formula? But the formula is here phi r, let this be phi r. So here our formula is for of phi r is 2a cos alpha by 2. Okay. A is here nothing but magnitude. A is magnitude and alpha is the angle. So, what is the angle? 60, and A is magnitude, that is root 3 by 2. Now, after substituting the values, what will be the output? That is 2 into root 3 by 2 into cos 60 by 2, that is 30. So, after solving this, what we will get the answer? Here, our answer will be root 3 by 2 into, or we can say the answer will be 3 by 2. Why? Because this 2 will get cancelled and cos 30 will be root 3 by 2. So root 3 into root 3, it will be 3 and it divided by 2. So it is 3 by 2. Okay, our answer of resultant is 3 by 2. So we can write here as phi r is equal to 1.5 m. So this is at the first point. Okay, this is at the first point. So just remember the direction. So this is our direction. So this is our direction of at the first point. This is our direction. Now what we will do? We will take the second point and then draw this vector. So at second point, that means at the 60 degree. Okay, this is 60 degree. So we will calculate phi 1, phi 2, and phi 3 at 60 degree. So what is angle of or the flux, this phi 1 at 60 degree? So it will be positive, that will be root 3 by 2. Again of the phi 2, it is negative, this will be minus root 3 by 2. And phi 2, what is phi 2? So here you can see, this is the phi 2, sorry, something went wrong. So this is of flux phi 1, it is positive. This is of second, which is negative, so here it will be negative root 3 by 2. And for phi 3, here you can see this is the phi 3, it is passing through the 60, that means it is 0. Okay, this is 0. So what we did, we have chosen here 60 degrees at the second point. For the second point, we have taken the 60. Now the flux phi 1, it is positive, so it will be root 3 by 2 after substituting these values here. And now phi 2, it will be, so this is our phi 2, this pink is phi 2, it will be negative, so it will be minus root 3 by 2. And third one, it is passing from 0, so it is 0. So we will draw this diagram with reference of this. So phi 3 is 0, so no need to draw this. Now phi 1 is positive, so we will keep this direction same, positive. And here phi 2 is negative, right? So we have to transfer this on this side. So this is negative. Okay, now to find resultant, same way we can find the resultant. So according to parallelogram law, this will be our resultant. So this is our resultant. So same resultant, that is 1.5 phi m, phi r is equal to 1.5 phi m. So now just look at the direction. So the direction is in this way. Okay, now consider the third point. Okay, now consider the third point. So here you can see at 120 degrees, phi 1 is, it is positive. At, you can see at 120 degrees, phi 1 is positive. So here the phi 1 is root 3 by 2. Phi 2 is, now the second, that is pink one, from the 120 it is passing, right? So it, phi 2 is 0. And now phi 3 will be minus root 3 by 2. So here phi 2 is not calculated, or we have to not draw the phi 2 because it is 0. Now phi 1, it is root 3 by 2, that means it will remain the same. phi 1 will remain same and phi 3 is minus root 3 by 2. That means this will go in the negative direction. It will extend in this direction. So I will just extend this in this direction. And now according to parallelogram law, we can calculate the resultant. So this will be our resultant. Now just observe the direction of our resultant. So it is in this direction. So whenever you go on calculating this resultant, now for the fourth point, that is at 180 degrees, at 180 degrees I will draw here, at 180 degrees you can see the phi 1 is 0. Okay, this is phi 1, it is passing through 180. So phi 1 is equal to 0. Okay, now phi 2, that is this pink line, it is positive. So phi 2 is root 3 by 2 and the third one is negative. So phi 3 is equal to minus root 3 by 2. So according to this we will draw the vector. So here you can see phi 1 is 0. So no need to draw this. Phi 2 is positive. So same we have to draw. This is positive phi 2 and phi 3 is negative. So what we have to do? We have to just extend this phi 3 here. So this will be like this. And so our resultant will be here. Okay. This is our resultant of fourth. So now here just observe the resultant. So it is in this direction. Then at second, this is at the first position. Now second, it has went to this. Third, it has went to this. And fourth, it has went to this position. Okay. From here, it started rotating. So now whenever we calculate further, that is, this is at the fourth position, right? So whenever we go on calculating for the next, this resultant will rotate, right? That means it is producing rotating magnetic field. So this, it will progress in this direction and our flux at zero is like this. Then it will go in this direction. Then it will go in this direction and it will be rotating. So this is how the rotating magnetic flux is produced. I hope you have understood. If you have any doubts in this, then you can ask. So in further lectures, we will see next part of this. We will see the advantages, what are the drawbacks. We will see next lecture.